think the only where I disagree on the model is the shift to just B2C at the moment. I think a B2B model is still something that's doable, and to keep your cost, like Asif mentioned, you need to have the revenue going. How do you create sustainability? Where the COVID situations are happening and schools are adopting technology more so for students, I think sticking to your ideas of also being B2B should be there in addition to B2C. That will keep your revenue going. And everybody sitting at home will have more time to be able to answer questions and to be able to go through the routine that you have prepared, rather than in a school environment where they already have a day planned versus at home, you know, and there is no limitation of time when you could actually utilize this. So so I think that's something that I would want you to look at. But sure. Besides that, I'm okay.
Sure.
Okay, Ed, time's up.
Thank you.
Yusuf, sir, have any questions?
Thank you for the comments. Niji, I'm fine. Thank you.
Okay. So who is coming next for the presentation? For the pitch, sorry. Who else do we have? Mehroz? Mehroz, Queen? Ayaz? Junaid? Anyone?
Yeah, I can go next. This is Ayaz. I can go
okay.
next.
Okay, Ayaz. Welcome. Please share your screen.
Bring it up.
Okay, let me know when you guys can see the screen.
Yeah, we can see the screen. You can start.
Awesome. So, assalamu alaikum, everyone. This is Sheikh Ayaz Ali. I am the founder and CEO for Go Spark. It is an interaction-driven smart buying platform. So the problem we're trying to solve is, in the post-COVID era, retail businesses, physical and e-com, both transform, and they need a cost-effective digital platform that drives consistent and measurable results. So currently you have the newspaper, TV, radio, which is too expensive. You have WhatsApp, SMS, email marketing, which has very low conversion rate. And then finally you have the mammoth digital platforms where you have to add an agency, invest in paid ads to be able to get some benefit out of it. So the solution has to be something that enables the digital transformation, understands the retail business, digital marketing, and the consumer mindset. So it should drive measurable traffic, it should facilitate the engagement, and it should provide analytics and retention. So GoSpark helps businesses to attract, engage, and retain customers through offering attractive deals to consumers. Simply put, we are a business listing platform like Yelp, combined with the power of deals like Groupon, and powered by loyalty, which keeps customers and users hooked to us. We work in all these 12 different categories, including physical and digital businesses. This is the team. We are three co-founders. This is our third business together. In the past businesses, we've made revenues of $6 million plus. And this is the team that we already have in place. This is a quick traction overview. The web and mobile apps are live. We have a proven history of tech, so that will never be a problem. The platform is robust, scalable, and integration ready. We have all these payment gateways already integrated. We have 26,000 users already on the platform. We have 2,800 listed businesses, out of which 18 are premium. And we have facilitated 30,000 total transactions on the platform, out of which 16,000 were actual redemptions at the stores pre-COVID. These are some of our examples of the deals that went live, where we sold 300 to 700 units in less than 24 to 48 hours, and these were actual redemptions. From business model perspective, the basic model is we charge rupees 5,000 per month to businesses to come on our premium plan, which allows them to campaign twice a month. Then we, as the traffic starts coming up more and more, we start to have rising revenue. Then we have the B2B model, where we can sell the partner network to different businesses like airlines, banks, etc. We can white label the app for different countries. We have a partner loyalty program idea that we will be talking about later, in the next few years. And then we have the franchising option for other countries. Our current user acquisition cost is 200 rupees a user, which is way less than what the industry average is. This is the competition. We've got discount platforms, food logistics, business listings, e-commerce, but we're none of that. We've taken the powerful thing from every model, combined it into one, and put it to work for the startups and SME businesses. This is the retail sector in Pakistan is $152 billion market. We are asking for $300,000 for 15% equity at post-money valuation of $2 million. Why $2 million? We've tried to explain that. We're doing it.
All right, time. Thumbs up.
Thank you.
Over to the mentors.
Correct me if I'm wrong. This is not an idea that you started coming in FI. It looks like, you know, you started this before and you're part of the FI, center right now. Is that correct?
Yeah, that is correct. We went live in April 2019. So we've been at it.
Because you have 30,000, orders. So that shows. Anyway, so a question that, the Groupon kind of model operated in Pakistan and there were two, which got very, very famous. I think Deal Today's and go to lootlo.pk. So have you been able to, find the reason why they did not work in Pakistan? They were already scaling up and today they do not operate. And in fact, they raised significant amount of funding as well. And then the founders, went away. And maybe you can combine my second question is that what is, a repetitive business of a business that, comes for the first time, offers you a discount offer. And what is the cycle that after how many weeks or months they're coming back and they're offering the same deal?
Okay. So answering your first question regarding all these deal platforms that used to exist, I think what we found out from all our research, talking to the businesses who were engaged with them, and then also having the chance to talk to some of the ex-founders, I think there was a problem in the business model because you were asking the business to give 50% or 60% off on a certain thing. And then you were again charging some percentage of commission on that amount. So eventually what the businesses had to do is they had to move away from you at some point in time because you're just not sustainable. And that is what proved over time is, businesses just stopped working with them or they had to move towards, getting some things from China and just putting those deals up. So that was our understanding. The problem was in the business model and how this worked. What we are doing, we're not charging commissions off of the deals and things like that. We are a digital platform. Our vision is to become the primary digital platform of Pakistan. This is where a business that starts, that wants to work in the digital environment, before going to Facebook, they come to Ghostpark because Ghostpark delivers results. So that's the major difference between us and what happened in the past. Even in the current scenario, there are a couple of competitors who are trying to replicate the same thing in a different way, but I think the business model there also has a problem. We're not Dubai or any other country. We have to think Pakistan.
Great. I understand. So what's a reordering cycle of the business?
So every business, when we onboard them, we give them first month as free trial, which gives them one deal that we campaign for them. Then once they come on the featured business, it's 5,000 rupees a month. So they will pay month over month. And then every month, we give them twice the option to campaign on our platform.
Okay, I get it. Thanks.
Yeah. And we go for a minimum 3 months contract with any premium vendor.
If there is no other question, so my next question is, why you don't have any, you know, top of the mind brands like Pizza Hut, Burger King, KFC, McDonald's? Have they refused to partner with you or what? Because I didn't, all the orders that I saw were the names that I have actually never, you know, heard of them.
Mostly these are smaller brands, small to mid-level brands that are working with us right now. The problem with Pizza Hut, KFC and all these bigger brands is right now, since the user base we have is small, that is what is becoming a problem in us having to talk to them. And then two, all the different guys already in the market like Golutlo and these, they've already, even Food Panda, the delivery services guys, the kind of deals they have struck with these bigger brands have a different, you know, it's kind of going to be a different way that we enter into these brands and give, you know, make them on board.
But you know what, you maybe you don't have to go to that. You know, your data is saying that you have actually identified a market segment that is big, that is, you know, way bigger, because there are smaller chains out there in every locality. So maybe these food pandas, and, you know, maybe they're missing on this part, and you have identified that market and you need to go aggressive on, you know, bringing these more and more outlets to your platform. So maybe your strategy could be to actually avoid them and, you know, capture more of this. Because this is what your data is saying.
Yeah, sure. I think this whole COVID situation has broken the backs of many big brands. So I think this is going to be an opportunity for us to get in, because when things start to reopen as they are now, then they would need every option they have to go out market and increase their sales.
Time's been up for a bit. So I think we should move on.
If Yusuf Saab or Noman Saab has any questions.
Yes. Yeah, I had a question. Maybe I missed this during your presentation, but how do you onboard the businesses? I mean, you do marketing, or do you need to have face-to-face meetings? Main to onboarding kaise ek sawal tha. और इसके साथ ही था कि कुछ आप अपने नंबर्स शेयर करते हैं और कर सकते हैं, और मंथ ऑन मंथ ग्रोथ आपकी कैसे रही है, क्या परसेंटेज मंथ ऑन मंथ आपकी ग्रोथ रही है ओवर द लास्ट लेट्स से 6 मंथ्स.
जी, सो द ऑनबोर्डिंग प्रोसेस रिक्वायर्स फेस टू फेस इंटरेक्शन यूसुफ साहब, बिकॉज़ मोस्ट ऑफ द बिजनेसेस इन द काइंड ऑफ बिजनेसेस वी आर टारगेटिंग दे आर नॉट दैट टेक सेवी, सो उनको we create their profile and we help them, you know, give them a demo of the administrative features they have. And then we explain them how this whole process is going to work. So each meeting requires about 30 to 45 minutes at max. And then the business gets onboarded. And after that, everything is on WhatsApp. So after that, then there's no real physical interaction required on a day-to-day or a month-to-month basis. So that's the answer to first question. And then second, the growth of month over month, you know, we have a different document for that. So I'm short of time right now, but I would love to share with you later.
Okay, thank you.
Noman sir.
Thank you.
The only thing that I think, and I've spoken to Ayaz about this earlier, is also having some additional revenue channels which are there in addition to the 5,000 subscription, you know. And in terms of the slide that we were seeing right now, just before this, Ayaz, if you could go back to that. So if you're selling a unit for 300 rupees, maybe having some kind of a commission-based model there as well, you know, which could add in some additional value to, or some additional revenue to your business. Going, because these are small businesses, this is a good target market, and a lot of people do order from here. But how do you increase your revenue by getting all this there, you know, and creating that stickiness as well?
Sure. We'll definitely think about that.
Yeah. But I think the model is well presented. It's a doable model. The cost of marketing will be the biggest challenge. And to bring the customers back onto the platform to be able to utilize a deal, that is the only challenge that is there, that which I can see.
Yep, makes sense.
Good presentation. Thank you. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, Jee, thank you very much. And next, Muin has volunteered. So next, Muin, please can you share your screen? Share your presentation.
Moin bhai, you're on mute if you're talking.
Screen sharing. Should we start?
आपकी
आवाज
नहीं आ रही. हेलो जी,
या वी कैन सी योर स्क्रीन एज वेल.
हेलो एवरीबॉडी, माय नेम इज गुलाम मोइनुद्दीन. आई एम लीडिंग एंटरप्राइज टेक्नोलॉजी सॉल्यूशन एंड सर्विसेज कंपनी व्हिच इज in short, it is a Square Private Limited now. It is a Square Solution and Services is providing the following services. We are also providing IT solutions for secondary sales model, which the companies which are using the secondary cell manufacturer. Our target audience are we are not focusing multinational companies. We are focusing companies which are Pakistan based. So my solution is automatic secondary sales through distributor channel. My business model is no capex required. I am working on SaaS model, pay as per use. Our solution is flexible, which support innovation and customization. We have an experienced team with product development experience since 2002. Our other services are IT operation services. We are providing all vertical of IT operations. My team is include Mr. Umar Altaf for mobility, sales and marketing is Hassan, and cloud architecture is Mr. Reed. There is no centralized online sales system available for secondary sales for modern and general trade. Because of this, the problems are the scheme cannot be updated because of the centralization. If a manufacturer wants to raise some schemes which was difficult to which take almost 2 or 3 days to replicate throughout Pakistan, and we are and there is no ordering automated ordering mechanism in current available systems. So we are going to solve these issues. Our solution ATS Square is developing an AI based IT solution to the organization to get optimal benefit of their Salesforce distribution network by automating their daily itinerary, optimize route with the help of geotagging for GT and MT, which is centralized data managing scheme, which also help to reduce carbon footprint. My solution name is Leverage. We want to resolve the following challenges for secondary sales. We are providing the centralized database for connecting distributor and manufacturer, online monitoring of DSR, distributor sales representatives, automating distributors ordering as per certain rules which are set by the manufacturer, providing flexibility to innovations, online update on SQL, automate claims tracking. Our solution is modular, so the user can buy as per they want. Geotagging and our solution, the specialty is also that we don't need any capex. So you don't need initial investment. We just need a certain amount of setup as an initial cost. My plan is initial is to go live in October 2020, but due to lockdown, there might be some risk, and I am trying to get it done on time.
Mine, sir, time is up.
So my initial investment I need is around 4.5 million PKR.
Okay, so over to the mentors now.
Mohin sahab, aapne start mein bhi bike start ki, end mein bhi bike start ki. So, Bhaji, ek question jo hai, wo ye bataiye ki aap kisi FMCG company ke andar rahe hain ya FMCG ke kisi distributor ke saath attached hain? Because aapne jo terminologies andar use ki hain, GT, MT, modern trades and unke secondary sales. So, kuch past mein aapka experience raha hai? Bhaji, aapne unke liye kuch develop kiya hai?
जी, आई वर्क इन यूनिलीवर, अराउंड 17 ईयर एक्सपीरियंस मेरे पास यूनिलीवर का है और सेकेंडरी सेल्स का. आई वर्क सेंटजी के साथ 2002 से ही मैंने मतलब प्रोडक्ट डेवलपमेंट का काम किया था उनके साथ.
आई एम आल्सो एक्स लीवर्स, सो ये बड़ी हार्डकोर उनकी इंटरनल टर्म्स हैं, डीबीआर,
यू नो,
स्टॉक एवरेज.
सो दैट्स व्हाई आई सही कह रहे हैं
जी. तो ये बेसिकली आपने एक अंदर रहते हुए आपने देखा कि जो एमटीज हैं उनकी जो ऑर्डर बुकिंग है, आई एम श्योर आपने लीवर्स में रहे, तो लीवर्स में तो उनकी एचएसटी टर्मिनल्स होते हैं जो कि वो ऑर्डर बुकिंग के वक्त ले रहे होते हैं, एमटीज वगैरह जो उनके जो स्पेशल जी ऑर्डर बुकर्स होते हैं, तो वो एचटीटीपी यूज कर रहे थे. तो डू यू थिंक दैट दिस इज अ चैलेंज फॉर मेनी स्मॉल कंपनीज दैट दे आर डीलिंग विद एमटी मॉडर्न ट्रेड?
हाँ, अब एचटी को रिप्लेस कर दिया, जो एंड्रॉइड फोन आता है 10-15 हज़ार रुपए का तकरीबन, तो उससे रिप्लेस कर दिया. एचटीटी वाज वेरी कॉस्टली, यू आर एब्सोल्युटली राइट. तो अब वो सिस्टम तो खैर खत्म हो गया, वो पुरानी चीज हो गई, अब एचटीटी पे तो शायद कोई काम ही नहीं कर रहा.
अच्छा, मुझे क्विकली माय क्वेश्चन इज कि ये आप हाउ डू यू सी योरसेल्फ डिफरेंट देन एनहांसेड, जिनकी सेकंड प्रेजेंटेशन थी, उन वो भी तो मॉडर्न ट्रेड और जीटी को दोनों को हैंडल कर रहे होंगे. So what is missing in their presentation that you're offering, or you both startups are all going after the same market? That's also fine, but just a question.
जी, we are ये फवाद के साथ जो है हमारा और तकरीबन इनका एक सा solution था, लेकिन we have some differences के जिसमें जो schemes हैं वो बड़ी challenging होती है और claim striking है जो कि वो challenging है. तो there is a possibility कि हम आपस में मिल भी जाए एट लेटेस्ट है. तो अभी वो लॉकडाउन की वजह से कुछ मीटिंग्स भी नहीं हुई थी, क्योंकि वी हैव एक्सपीरियंस, मेरे पास ज़्यादा एक्सपीरियंस है मल्टीनेशनल का और सेकेंडरी सेल्स का. तो इट कुड बी पॉसिबल कि हम एक अलग से मतलब प्रोडक्ट लेके चले.
और आपने आपने अपने बिजनेस मॉडल की प्राइसिंग कुछ नहीं बताई कि क्या, हाउ यू
कार्ड प्राइसिंग? तो आगे 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 जा रहा था मैं, तो वो टाइम खत्म हो गया था. तो
चलो ठीक है, आई एम गुड हियर. ओके, Maybe you can see the slide here. आप दिखाते हैं यहाँ पे.
जो इसका मेरा चार्जिंग मैकेनिज्म मेरे से हो रहा है 3000 to 5000 per users for initial setup charges we are charging and 10,000 to 500 depending on the complexity of the customer.
ठीक है सर. कोई सक्सेस हुई है अभी तक? कोई सक्सेस हुई है या तो अभी आप मेरे पास प्री रेवेन्यू प्री लॉन्च है, राइट?
प्री लॉन्च. यस, ऑफ कोर्स.
अच्छा, ठीक है, ओके. Best of luck.
Okay, thank you.
Jee, Yusuf sahab, Numan sahab, any questions from your side?
No, I'm fine. Thank you.
None from my side also. Thank you.
Okay, great. So, Mohin sahab ki pitch was perfect. There are no questions.
So, gala kharab hai mera, sorry. Awaaz nahi nikal rahi thi.
Really, it's okay. So, who is coming next? I think ab kaun reh gaya hai? Muin, would you like to come next?
Junaid Raga.
CPEC. जी मुइन साहब चले मुइन साहब आ रहे हैं मुइन कोरी जी बिस्मिल्लाह
My name is Mohammad Mohinuddin Ghori and I am the co-founder of CPEC directory. CPEC directory is basically developing a B2B digital marketplace where sellers will get business leads from the buyers who are sourcing their products online. From the people's looking for products on their mobile and laptops. We are basically solving some very basic problems of buyers and sellers. One, buyers जब market में होते हैं तो वो तलाश कर रहे होते हैं कि उन्हें product best quality की और reasonable price में मिल जाए. Second, उनका problem ये होता है कि जो reliable distributors हैं, wholesalers हैं, where are they? और इसके अलावा तीसरा जो problem होता है, जो companies के साथ basically होता है, वो ये है कि जो भी product उन्हें purchase करनी होती है, they demand at least three quotation. Yes. Sorry sir. They require at least three quotations against purchasing any product. इसी तरह sellers के भी problems हैं. Sellers का जो बुनियादी problem है वो है customer acquisition cost. अमूमन ये sellers इससे पहले जो है billboards वगैरह purchase किया करते थे मुख्तलिफ शहर के locations के ऊपर billboards लगे होते थे. They are costing around something 50,000 to 70,000. एक्सपोज अटेंड करते थे वो 6 लाख 8 लाख रुपए ने चार्ज करता था इसके अलावा ब्रांड मार्केटिंग ऑनलाइन प्रेजेंस दैट इज आल्सो वेरी कॉस्टली थिंग और इसके साथ साथ कोई बिजनेस फ्रेंडली मार्केटप्लेस भी इस वक्त अवेलेबल नहीं है अदर देन दास व्हाट वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग द सॉल्यूशन इज अ सर्च इंजन फॉर बायर एंड सेलर्स इसके ऊपर उनकी प्रोडक्ट जो है 24/7 ऑनलाइन होगी एक रिलायबल मतलब प्रोडक्ट्स होंगी और एक सिस्टमेटिक वे में प्लेस्ड होंगी जहां से वो उस प्लेटफॉर्म से ज्यादा बिजनेस लीड्स जनरेट कर सकेंगे और प्रॉफिट उनका इंक्रीज हो जाएगा प्लस वहां से बायर्स जो है मल्टीपल कोटेशंस हासिल कर सकेंगे अपनी कंपनीज के लिए ये कुछ प्रोडक्ट स्क्रीन्स हैं इस वक्त ये एमवीपी फेज में जो है ऑनलाइन हो चुका है और इसके ऊपर लोग मतलब विजिट कर रहे हैं We are targeting manufacturers, exporters, wholesalers, retailers, and service providers. जो हमारी target categories हैं, जो target industries हैं, उनमें auto parts, consumer electronics, machinery, parts, security products, ये तमाम हमारी target categories हैं जिन्हें हम target कर रहे हैं. Actual market size Pakistan और China का वो around $26 billion का है और Pakistan का $103 million जो है serviceable market है जो हम attend कर सकते हैं. लेकिन वी आर टारगेटिंग अराउंड $1 million ऑफ लोकल मार्केट ऑफ दीस कैटेगरीज ये कंप्यूटर्स ने हमारे जिनमें इंटरनेशनल कंप्यूटर्स में ईवर्ल्ड ट्रेड EC21 एंड अलीबाबा हैं जिनकी इस वक्त जो है मतलब मार्केट अप्रोच कर रहे हैं पाकिस्तान की लोकल मार्केट प्लेसेस में ट्रेड डायरेक्टरी ट्रेड की येलो पेजेस मौजूद है और इसमें EC21 और अलीबाबा जो है वो
मोइन 30 सेकंड
राइट ये हमारा जो है प्राइसिंग मॉडल है जिसके अंदर हमारी मेजॉरिटी जो है वो फ्री मेंबर्स हैं इसके साथ हम लीड हंटर और मार्केट लीडर के जो है प्लान्स ऑफर कर रहे हैं अब तक इस पे चाइना वियतनाम और पाकिस्तान से लोग अप्रोच कर रहे हैं और रजिस्टर्ड हो रहे हैं हमारा इरादा चाइनीज मार्केट को अप्रोच करने का है विद इन दिसंबर 2020 हमारी मार्केटिंग स्ट्रेटजी में हम सेमिनार्स डायरेक्ट मार्केटिंग और ऑनलाइन मार्केटिंग के जरिए जो है मार्केट को कैप्चर कर रहे हैं और सीपेक अथॉरिटी चाइनीज कॉन्सुलेट और ट्रेड एसोसिएशन से रابطہ कर रहे हैं ये हमारी टीम है जिसमें मायसेल्फ मोहम्मद मोइनुद्दीन और सुहेब एंड जीशान
जी. टाइम इज अप.
थैंक यू.
I have no questions at my end. I've been working with Moin separately as well to support him in the effort. So I have no questions at my end.
Hey, Yusuf Saab, do you have any questions?
मैं सिर्फ एक चीज मैंने मिस कर दी कि what is the state of this right now? Is there a marketplace up and running? Are there businesses there or what's the state right now?
Sir, marketplace is what run kar rahi hai, businesses roll ho rahe hain. Is waqt hame China, Vietnam aur Pakistan in teenon jagahon se jo hai businesses aa rahe hain kuch.
Kitne mai to kitne aaye hain, kya growth rate kya hai ya kuch batayenge, mai numbers batayenge?
सर अराउंड हम इसे जो है 2 months से प्रमोट कर रहे हैं और इस वक्त 550 प्लस जो है हमारे पास बिजनेसेस इनरोल हो चुके हैं, बट दोस आर ऑन सप्लीमेंट्री 3 months पीरियड सर.
ठीक, ओके, थैंक यू.
यार हाउ यू आर, यू नो आपकी जो प्रेजेंटेशन है उसमें जो आपने अपना ये एग्जैक्टली दिस स्लाइड आई वुड लाइक टू फोकस ऑन, आप लोग बेसिकली लोकल मार्केट को ज्यादा फोकस कर रहे हैं, पाकिस्तान के जो प्रोडक्ट्स हैं, इज दैट करेक्ट?
Exactly, sir.
Okay, so basically, फिर ये आपके जो business का नाम है CPEC directory, sounds like जब मैंने आपकी slide देखी तो मुझे लगा कि okay, if I need to find any supplier or you know company in CPEC, this is a place to go. Is that correct or it's just a name, you know, a catchy name?
नहीं sir, ये matter ये है कि initially हम जो target कर रहे हैं वो सीपेक रिलेटेड तमाम बिजनेसेस को कर रहे हैं, लेकिन इसके अलावा भी कोई बिजनेस हमारे पास इन्वॉल्व होना चाहता है तो दे कैन इन्वॉल्व. और इसके साथ साथ हम ये भी ट्राई कर रहे हैं कि पाकिस्तान की जो नॉन डिजिटल मतलब सेलर्स हैं उन तमाम को डिजिटाइज करते हैं, उन्हें एक स्टोर फ्रंट दे.
अच्छा, जो पाकिस्तान के सप्लायर्स हैं उनको आप डिजिटाइज कर रहे हैं टू बी पार्ट ऑफ दिस मार्केटप्लेस, ऑनलाइन मार्केटप्लेस. सो वो कौन से अभी तक जो आप लोग के पास जो बिजनेसेस आए हैं वो कौन सी कैटेगरीज हैं जो कि अलीबाबा पे नहीं थी और यहाँ पे आपने प्रोवाइड की?
सर अलीबाबा तो काफी बड़ा जाइंट है और मैटर इस पर ब्लैकनेस का ये आ रहा है कि अलीबाबा जो मिनिमम चार्ज कर रहा है दैट इज अराउंड $1500 सर.
नहीं नहीं नहीं, मैं कस्टमर की बात कर रहा हूँ. कस्टमर क्या उसको वहां नहीं मिल रहा था जो यहाँ पे आप प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं, जो अलीबाबा पे नहीं मिल पाया था? बिकॉज दैट्स हाउ यू नो पीपल आर सर्चिंग, राइट? समथिंग आई कुड नॉट फाइंड ऑन दराज एंड दैट इज व्हाई आई एम गोइंग ऑन ये वो मे बी, बिकॉज दैट्स अ पीएसएल के जो टिकट्स होते हैं वो दराज पे नहीं मिलते, पीएसएल मिलते. तो इसी तरीके से आपकी वेबसाइट पे वो कौन सी कैटेगरीज आपने अभी तक फाइंड आउट की हैं जो कि बेसिकली हॉट सेलिंग थी या फिर वो अवेलेबल नहीं थी अलीबाबा पे, और अलीबाबा को कितना टाइम लगेगा वो कैटेगरीज को ऑनबोर्ड करने के लिए, या आपका सस्टेनेबल एडवांटेज क्या होगा?
सर अलीबाबा के ऊपर तो जाहिर है एक बड़ा जायंट मॉडल है, उनके पास तकरीबन तमाम कैटेगरीज मौजूद होंगी जो इस वक्त हम मतलब अपने पास लिस्ट किए हुए हैं और जिन्हें हम टारगेट कर रहे हैं. बट द मैटर इज अलीबाबा की तरफ वो फर्क जा रहा होता है कि जो किसी भी चीज को इम्पोर्ट कराना चाहे जो पाकिस्तान में अवेलेबल नहीं है. What we are working for is हम पाकिस्तान के अंदर जितने भी buyers and sellers हैं पहले उन सबको आपस में connect कर रहे हैं ताकि अगर आप जो product search करना चाह रहे हैं अगर वो local market में available है और अगर वो आपकी eyes से hide हुई हुई है तो हम उसे आपके सामने लेकर initial हम local market को develop करेंगे. local market को develop करने के बाद फिर we will go global.
अच्छा सर, वो question repeat कर रहा हूँ, कौन सी categories आपके सामने आई जिस पे लोग सर्च करके आपके पास आ रहे हैं?
सर उसके अंदर इस वक्त जो है होटल टूरिज्म है, पावर टूल्स वगैरह की कैटेगरीज है हमारे पास, कंज्यूमर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स हैं, और ये सारी कैटेगरीज हैं जिसके जरिए लोग हमें अप्रोच करते हैं.
ठीक है, ओके.
और अभी तक कोई पेड आपका पेड कस्टमर नहीं आया आपके पास, राइट? इट्स ऑल कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री, जो आपके जितने कस्टमर्स आए 50 वो दे ऑल फ्री.
which is fine because jo aap marketplace bana rahe hain wahan pe to aapke suppliers hain, you need to get them on board you know as much as possible, so that's fine. And lekin abhi tak koi paid nahi aaya aapke paas. Theek hai.
Okay ji, thank you very much. And Muin for the pitch, and next we have Junaid lined up. Junaid, are we ready? Okay, great.
Is my screen visible?
Yes, that's visible.
आपकी आवाज थोड़ी कम आ रही है जुनैद.
अच्छा, okay, I'll speak louder. So my venture is Enermizer for Energy Optimizer. My name is Junaid Tahir. So the cheapest
Junaid,
form of energy
कम आवाज आ रही है.
Is it okay now?
Yeah.
Okay, great. Thank you. So the cheapest form of energy is one that you don't need to use at all. And megawatts, which is interchangeably used with energy efficiency, is actually in many cases 6 times cheaper than solar. Yes, 6 times. So we want to kickstart this journey, and you know, of 1,000 miles, which begins with a single step. So this first single step is obviously the energy audit that we do. The problem is basically, you know, connects with Sustainable Development Goal 7. Firstly, consumers and governments are not aware of the energy saving opportunities. Secondly, there is no one-stop implementation solution. And thirdly, there is absence of low-cost energy-saving products, even if consumers are interested to save. So the solution obviously addresses all three. So in short, it's an audit and it's an implementation and it's a combination of products used to save 30% of energy spent for multiple consumer segments. We're targeting 30% of the market. So basically, we provide financial incentive to create traction, integrate with other players in the industry and develop or procure low cost energy saving products. So the product obviously starts off with an energy audit, and then it can lead to 4 options which are not mutually exclusive. So there is embedding of energy management, maybe some certification like ISO 50001 or some learnings from SEED or Energy Star. So this can save as much as 10%. Then there is training and accountability within the organization, which is often lacking. Then it can lead to implementation of the steps from the audit. So these two can save as much as 20% of the energy. And then energy saving products, which you know, help monitor and save energy, which can save as much as 10%. So this is just a snapshot of some of the material that we've done. The key thing to note is that any finding or recommendation is backed up by the cost for it and the benefit for it. So at the end of the day, the customer is not making an expense, rather an investment, and he knows how many months or years it's going to take for the investment to come out positive. So this is some material from our marketing. So we claim to help customers to save 30% of their bill. The savings will last for 10 years. In case of appliances and 25 in cases of architecture. So let's example, if we optimize appliances and the client saves, let's say 10,000 a month, this saving will last for more than 10 years. So say 120 months. So this 10,000 is actually 1.2 million. And if it's some architectural optimization, this 10,000 is actually 3 million. So we assume that this is a huge saving that the customer would be willing to leverage. In terms of traction, we've touched base with about 200 customers. We've done projects for about 5-6 segments: residential, shops, offices, restaurants, factories. So we've gotten sufficient understanding of the pain points of the customers. So the business model is basically, for different options that I laid out, it's basically in some cases upfront fee, in some cases it's consulting fee, and in some cases commission on the product. So this is something that we've explored over time with customers and what they are willing to pay. In terms of the market size, only for Karachi, if we target, for the top 30% properties are about 1 million. And this presents a revenue opportunity of about 2 billion to about 7 billion. And if we scale this to the rest of Pakistan, this number could go as high as 10 times. In terms of the competition, most of them are focused on large organizations and they are not very financially focused. So basically our difference is that we are focusing on different types of organizations and different types of sectors, and we are hyper focused on the financial part. And the market is hugely untapped for the key, competitors. We've seen only 200 implementations. So out of 1 million, about 99.9% of the market is untapped so far. In terms of the growth model, so there are different strategies for different segments. But let's say for industrial, we...
Time is up. Sorry, Junaid.
Okay, sure.
Okay, ji. Can you, Junaid, come to the last slide? Aapki jo team slide hogi. Okay, fine.
Yeah.
So, over to the mentors for Q&A, please.
I have an academic question, and that is, aapki jo customer acquisition time hai, wo hai, how it starts, and you know, cycle kab kitne time mein complete hoti hai? Because cost zarur ek overall koi bhi business owner jo hai wo ye zarur dekh raha hota hai ki meri overall cost kya hai, aur agar electricity ki usme dekhi jati hai to hota hai ki yaar किस तरीके से हमने कॉस्ट कम करनी है, या फिर ऐसा कोई टूल है जो कि हम कंपनी में ऑफिसेस में लगाएं और हमारे इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बिल जो है वो कम हो जाए. यू नो, गोइंग इनटू डिटेल स्टडीज ट्रेनिंग्स एंड ऑल दैट, दैट्स अ नॉलेज फॉर मी. सो कैन यू प्लीज यू नो शेयर योर एक्सपीरियंस.
So basically, I can give you an analogy. Just say flywheel hota hai, initially aapko usko dhakka lagana padta hai, but once the momentum is there, then the customer acquisition is easier. But I agree, the first customer in a certain segment is very difficult, because obviously unke paas koi past koi reference point nahi hai. And specifically for industrial segment, currently the cycle is obviously quite long. It can take as long as a few months. For residential, I expect to in the scaling part, for residential, let's say my strategy was that do some implementations in an apartment complex and then use the word of mouth to make it a little viral, and so that was one aspect. So, and then maybe for industrial or commercial.
So, मैं as a customer जो हूँ, अगर उस apartment में रहता हूँ, तो आपका product मेरे लिए क्या है? Is it something plug-in that I can plug in my home and my bill will go down, or is it something that is spread over, consultation and doing what's right?
Yeah, it's
what's
wrong. So basically, it starts off with the audit, and then the audit identifies what is required to save that money, and that saving obviously. 10% of that saving can come with energy measurement and energy control devices. So basically, wo jo devices hain, wo basically aapko batati hain ki aap din ka ya aap ghante ka kitna istemal kar rahe hain. And if you buy a more expensive device, then they can even do on device level what you are consuming. But obviously, that device becomes so expensive, which is one of my key goals, to find a device which is much cheaper. But yes, it starts off with an audit, and then it culminates into awareness or implementation. Or a product, or all.
Or revenue? क्या है अभी तक?
So I've just done 20 projects. Let's say about 30% residential, some commercial, some industrial, and the just to get insight into the different sectors so far.
So revenue क्या है? The number that you can share, maybe a ballpark.
I can give you a projected revenue jo maine apna next 2 years ke liye estimate kiya tha. Again, this is based on, I would say,
nahi aaj jo 20 logon ke sath aapne consult kiya hai, wahan pe kya revenue raha overall, matlab mix bata dein.
I mean, dekhiye, so it would vary from, let's say, 2000 rupees per customer in some cases to 10,000 rupees for certain customers, so maybe a few lakh by now. So in terms of revenue so far, because this is just 20 audits done, it is not much at the moment.
So 2,000, 4,000, 5,000, wo aapki effort justify karta hai, aapki matlab cost cover ho jati hai usse?
Not yet, but obviously when I have cheaper, so I have about a decade and a half of experience, so definitely I completely agree with that. But I'm inducting cheaper resources who can do this at a lower cost, and who can do this faster. So I have tools and templates developed having done the audit. So obviously the first audit may have taken X amount of time. I expect to do it at, let's say, X divided by 4 or X divided by 2 in the subsequent audit. So obviously there is this journey of optimization that I need to make.
Sure. Thank you.
Thanks.
Yusuf Saab and Noman Saab, any questions?
I'm fine, thank you.
Okay, then Noman Saab.
None from my end as well. I'm already in touch with Junaid, so I'm aware of what's happening.
So, can I ask a question from Yusuf Saab? Yusuf Saab, so you've been, you know, leading Ignite for, you know, past many years. Was this an issue for you to, you know, manage, see NICs, how they're performing in terms of their, you know, electricity bill, and was there any concern? Is there any study or whatever? It's again an academic question.
I don't recall that I have done anything like that. I haven't done it, but generally speaking, the environmentally sound measures lene padte hain, as generally zahir hai bijli save karni hai, apna bill niche lana hai, us kisam ke maine dekhte hain.
Yeah, the reason why I asked this question, is it a burning, you know, desire of the businesses ke, or is it like, you know, top priority ke yaar electricity bill ke wo bahut focus karna hai? Because I've been managing my business for last 12 years, and you know, in the earlier part of the business, in early years of the businesses, you know, I was a little concerned that total expenses is other than chahiye, and of course electricity. But now, right now, it's not on my radar at all. So
different perspective hai, because jo ne shuru mein bhi jaise discuss kiya tha, one of the trends of course is companies are hurting for cash. I mean, I've spoken to even bigger companies, corporations, yeah. Everybody is hurting for cash. So when you're hurting for cash, and somebody says, kisi ka bill, jo bhi aa raha hai, kuch logon ka to crore mein aa raha hota hai, jo factories wagaira. Magar agar kisi ka lakho mein aa raha hai, koi kehta hai, main aapka 50,000 bhi chahta hoon. I think all that adds up per offer.
Yeah, sure. At this time, I think it make a lot of sense. But traditionally, jaise maine aapne bataya ki jo hai wo, matlab was never really a concern for managing NICs and all. Was also, you know, my thought were also in line with that. But you're right, you know, business is hurting big time, and anything that can help to save money right now is no brainer, I guess.
So can I comment on this? So yeah. NIC, I've been to NIC quite a few times, the Karachi one, so it's very environmentally sound comparatively. Yeah, but I do have a list of measures that I could maybe share with Yusuf Saab, although I don't think that he's in the role anymore. You know, being hyper focused or compulsive with this, whenever I go to such places, I note down some key measures. Secondly, I think jo aapne kaha na ke businesses are not focused on this, so that's the opportunity, that's the iceberg within the sea, which is lying, which is very much there and not very visible. And obviously, kuch companies ka energy spend takriban 5% of the total cost hoga, aur kuch companies ka 15% hoga. So imagine if you save, let's say, 30% of it for 10 years, that becomes a huge number, you know, with the minimal effort that is required. Obviously, company khud nahi kar sakti, but ek expert ko bulati hai, so they will do it much faster than themselves doing it.
Yeah, I think the bigger market side is for the industrial usage, jahan pe ye bahut contribution jo expenses ki hoti hai, bahut badi hoti hai.
Yeah.
So sir, focus वहाँ करें आप, मतलब जो हमारा जो feedback है कि consumer side पे तो bill बहुत बड़े भी नहीं होते और लोगों ने अपने expenses में उसको mark किया हुआ होता है, तो industrial side पे, business side पे जहाँ पे expense बहुत ज़्यादा है, so I think that's a go-to area for you, and this is maybe the right time to approach all these people.
ठीक है, thanks.
All right guys, let's move on. Thank you, Junaid.
Okay,
Please start this presentation. I would request Asif, if you can share your contact details so we can forward to the founder.
Atik, we can start. We are good to start.
Sorry, I messaged kar diya. This is Yusuf. I will just beg leave. I have another meeting at 1.
Okay, we have this last presentation. If you can, just 2 minutes. This is the last presentation.
I'll just message you.
Okay, thank you.
Hello, assalamualaikum. Am I audible?
Yes, you are.
Yes.
Thank you. My name is Adigur Rahman. My startup's name is Committee. The option, the opportunity we are looking for is, as we know, Pakistan's economy has a large range of problems. One of the major problems is financial exclusion. The major reasons we see for financial exclusion are faith sensitivity, lack of awareness about finance and investing methods, excessive documentation and legal complexities, and reliance on informal saving and understandable methods of saving. What we are focusing on is one of the informal saving methods, that is community saving methods. As we see on this snapshot I've taken from State Bank's financial exclusion website, a committee is recognized as one of the saving methods under the microfinancing bank. The solution we are providing is a digital platform to manage committees. Since it is an informal method of saving, we want to regularize this type of method in the economy. We want to make a microfinance institution working around committee saving methods. We want to make it transparent, agile, and approachable platform. We want to make investments available in more than one committees and asset financing through committees. We want to ensure limited KYCs for onboarding such customers to reduce the legal complexities. And integration of payment gateways and collaboration with established financial institutions. What the product will be, it will be a mobile application, desktop portal, and non-digital product we are working on. The target audience we look forward are initially we'll be targeting the salaried individuals, then the business individuals and households, and finally the SMEs. We'll create pools for SMEs also based on this type of model. What the business model around is participation as a company in the committees also, which will ensure that we have deposits available to invest further in investment areas and earn revenue. The second thing is we will charge a management fee, though the committee model does not appreciate charging of management fee. However, we will charge management fee on the larger committee, not on the smaller committees. One of the key features that we want to incorporate is return sharing on the committee committees. On the people getting committees at the later stage or the number at the later stage will get the return. Second thing we'll look after at the next stage will be integrated from e-commerce and asset financing through committees. Currently, we are ready with the prototype. However, the prototype needs user interface, and that is what we are working on. We've made an initial prototype. As I said, the user interface is in progress, and landing page will be launched by the end of this month. With respect to traction, we are currently testing 20 customers on board with the operational model we are working on. This is a basic financial projection that we have made with an increasing average growth of 25% participants on a quarterly basis down the line, and it's an average growth rate. The initial investment includes the licensing cost also. Since this is a very regularized area, we look forward to get a license of NBFC, and the initial investment requires that also. The competition we are looking, there's not much competition in the market right now.
30 seconds.
However, we have Udaan and Pace Financials working on, and we have informal groups on Facebook working around that we are targeting. The team includes me, myself. I'm a qualified chartered accountant, and the other two members are also chartered accountant, Rizlan Hassan Qazi and Mohammed Muzam Manaf. And we have Zishan Dalil as a technical guy who is the CTO of the company. Thank you. That is.
Thank you very much. Over to the mentors. As Yusuf Saab had to leave, so if we can ask questions if he has any. Yusuf Saab.
My question was that what is your go-to-market, and where exactly are you, and what kind of traction and growth have you seen?
As I said, currently we are at this stage of finalizing our product. We have created a dashboard, and we have created the initial product. However, we'll launch it publicly in a month or so. currently we are testing 20 customers. We have identified 20 customers in friends and family. We're testing on them. And once we launch, then we have a large range of customers we have testing. We have done particular surveys on this also.
Okay, thank you.
Ji, Numan sir, yeah, Asif
sir. My only, I think Atik has already covered most of my comments that I've always given him during the discussions. And the only thing I have a concern on is the licensing, you know. And so as soon as you do start marketing, once your product is up and running, SEC or the State Bank or somebody will reach out and stop you to do what you're trying to do. You know, and so I think that's something that you should be very, very careful of before you actually go to market and do this officially. Jab tak aap unofficially kar rahe hain, jaise Facebook ke groups chal rahe hain, toh wo toh theek hai, but once you create that brand and go into social media marketing and all, be very, very careful from that respect and ensure that you have the correct licensing in place.
Yes, Duman, this has been an issue we have been discussing around throughout this program. What we are doing is that we initial product ko deposits initially nahi lenge. Hum initially administration ka kaam karenge, or we'll make it available on the dashboard. Meanwhile, we'll be working with financial institutions. Or directly bhi hum SECP ke saath collaborate kar rahe honge NBFC ka license lene ke liye and financial institutions ke saath bhi hum collaborate karne ki koshish karenge. Once hum kisi ek financial institution ke saath collaborate karne mein kamyab ho gaye, so then it will be easy to
I think you will have to be careful in terms of partnering with the financial institutions. You've said this before also in the presentations that you've made. The challenge is that whenever a financial institution comes in, like a Easy Paisa, for example, as a microfinance or a commercial bank as branches, all of them charge money in terms of deposit collections. So they will not do it for free. Right? So, yes. So the fact is that for committees where you'll be, there will be smaller committees, jisme 1,000 rupees, 2,000 rupees ko jama karwa rahe mahina, wo 150 rupees transaction charge to nahi dene wala. And that'll, jo aap return de bhi rahe, I'm glad that you've included it. Agar return aap de bhi rahe, it will not justify the cost every month. You know? So that is a concern as well. That's going to be there. So I think you have to be more innovative from that perspective. Ke paise collection aap kaise kare. Probably target people like a Pay Pro, you know, jo ke Connect Pay walon ka product hai, where you don't jo ke one link ke systems integrated hai. People like that, like them who require customers like you for collections, and rather you know, do it like a break and everything. Ke yaar hum jo hai wo. आपको आप चार्ज हम आपसे नहीं करेंगे कलेक्शन करने के लिए यू नो
ठीक यस आई गॉट इट थैंक यू
जी आस्टर
या सो मेरा क्वेश्चन ये है कमेंट है कि जब तक आप लोग अपनी ऐप बना रहे हैं ऐप लॉन्च कर रहे हैं तो आप लोग मार्केट को टेस्ट करने के लिए जैसे फेसबुक के पेजेस बने हुए हैं फेसबुक के लोग मैनेज कर रहे हैं So have you tried you know anything like that before? Manage kar rahe aur aap and they were okay you being there observing and helping them to participate each one.
Yes sir, as I said currently we are working with 20 participants on the product. Jis tarah ka humne operation banaya hai usi ke mutabik hum controls ke perspective se test kar rahe hain ki ye kitna kaam karta hai and how are we earning return. So we have an informal group that we are working on. Aur usse hum jo experiences learn kar rahe hain that will be included in the product as well.
Nahin, mera kehne ka maksad hai ke, you know, forget about your app, forget about your website. Maybe, you know, in order to understand ke yaar, log hamare, ye jo committee wali cheez hai, ki committee to hoti hai aur khas kar hamari khawateen jo isko manage kar rahi hoti hain. Almost har apartment ke andar koi na koi committee chal rahi hoti hai. कोई भी जो बिजनेस यूनिट्स बिजनेस सेंटर्स हैं वहां पे कोई ना कोई कमेटी चल रही होती है शॉपकीपर्स और ये सब लोग मैनेज कर रहे होते हैं तो यू नो अभी अगर आपका टाइम है कि जो आपकी प्लेटफॉर्म लॉन्च होगा आपकी एप्लीकेशन लॉन्च होगी उससे पहले गिव देम समथिंग फॉर फ्री टू यू नो प्ले विद उस पे आप कोई चार्ज नहीं कर रहे उस पे आप कोई पैसे नहीं बना रहे जस्ट टू सी कि यार लोगों का रिस्पॉन्स क्या है आर दे यू नो ट्रस्टिंग थर्ड पार्टी यू नो टू कम एंड become aware ke what's happening kaun kitne de raha hai aur kisi ki concerns so you know test that market
Yes, you're right. And that testing is in progress. Or initially, हम कोई charge करेंगे भी नहीं. What we'll be focusing on, participation in the committee अगर हमें कुछ return कमाना भी है. Initially, हम कोशिश यही कर रहे होंगे कि ज़्यादा लोगों को अपने trust building के लिए अपने platform पे लाएं और उनको test करें. Informal groups में तो हम already test कर रहे हैं इस पूरे process को and testing how consumer behave. But down the line, जब app भी होगी तो उसमें भी initially we'll not be charging.
अच्छा ओके सो और मेरा जो मैं खुद भी बड़ा चाहता हूँ कि यार मैं किसी कमेटी में पार्टिसिपेट करूँ और वहाँ पे लेकिन मैं मुझे कोई मिलता ही नहीं है प्लेटफॉर्म ही नहीं मिलता आई नो कि उड़ान है लेकिन somehow you know these financial by the way I don't know if they do this committee system I think they are a micro lending platform 5,000-10,000 I don't know iske alawa bahar agar jana hai and you know there are 20 odd trustable guys that you know and if your platform can take responsibility but I'm sure that you will not and you should not so how to you know navigate all of this
sir iske liye zaruri hai ki we go for the licensing first of all agar hume licensing mil jati hai NBFC ki and we jaise maine kaha ki hum koshish ye karenge ki kisi इदारे के साथ भी कोलैबोरेट करें वंस हम अगर इस तरह की कोई चीज कर पाते हैं एंड लाइसेंस अगर हमें मिल जाता है देन इट विल बी अ ट्रस्टवर्दी थिंग और आई थिंक इट विल वर्क
अच्छा मुझे पता है एनबीएफसी का लाइसेंस तो आई थिंक 50 मिलियन का है
नहीं 30 मिलियन का मिनिमम है एंड 100 मिलियन तक भी जाता है वो इन्वेस्टमेंट
तो यार इतनी इतनी बड़ी इन्वेस्टमेंट करने के बाद लेट्स सपोज अगर लोग प्रोडक्ट यूज नहीं करते बिकॉज़ एट द एंड ऑफ द डे इट्स अ प्रोडक्ट राइट एंड इफ नोबडी यूजेस इट सो why not to you know try this thing and you know scale it up jisme aap paisa hold nahi kar rahe aur paisa de nahi rahe and maybe you're giving them a platform that you know you're only managing it jahan pe aapko licensing ki zarurat nahi hai to yes, you know aap apni website launch kar rahe hain committee.com and you know wahan pe aaye log manage kare dekhen and see if people are responding to it as well why to go for license and you know take such a risk because in Pakistan, Udaan has not taken off, to the best of my information. You know, so why to risk such money? You know, why not to test the product so much? कि आपके पास यार एक महीने month on month आपके पास 10% 20% 30% growth आ रही है, and then you are going for license because then only it's worth taking a license. Or otherwise, if you have any other business plan.
You're right. Sir, अगर आप मेरी ये वाली स्लाइड देखें तो इस पर मैंने यही लिखा है कि मिनिमम वायबल प्रोडक्ट के बाद हम टेस्टिंग ऑफ प्रोडक्ट करेंगे देन लॉन्च कमिटीज एज एन एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर ओनली एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर से मुराद है कि मैं डिपॉजिट्स नहीं ले रहा एनबीएफसी की तरह और मैं लीगली इलीगल काम नहीं कर रहा हूँ कोई भी एज एन एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर मैं अपना प्लेटफॉर्म कमिटी होल्डर्स को दूंगा उसमें हम एजेंट्स को रख रहे होंगे लोग अपनी अपनी कमिटीज मैनेज करें और उनके पास प्लेटफॉर्म अवेलेबल होगा क्लोज ग्रुप टेस्टिंग होगी एंड ट्रैक्शन इस तरह मैनेज की जाएगी वंस वी गेट दैट ट्रैक्शन एंड वी गेट सफिशिएंट अमाउंट ऑफ कस्टमर्स और हमें नजर आ रहा होगा कि ये चीज काम कर रही है देन वी विल गो फॉर इंटरनेट कोलैबोरेशंस एंड सीड फंडिंग फॉर लाइसेंसिंग
ऑलराइट गाइस थैंक यू फॉर द डिस्कशन
आई
थिंक लेट्स हेड टुवर्ड्स आवर कंक्लूजन नाउ
या this was all from the founder side. Thank you very much all founders for your great and this is a moment of excitement I know for all of you the last presentation of the cohort just went by and alhamdulillah it was very good and very exciting projects that came up next I would like our respected mentors who have been giving time to all of you and giving their feedbacks and you know guiding and all their inputs so let's start with Yusuf Saab and I think Yusuf Saab has already left I don't see him here so next can we have Mr. Numan just say a few words about the whole semester your experience just 2-3 minutes
yeah absolutely thank you Hiram I think this was a great opportunity. I cannot thank Omar enough to be able to scout me for this. And
It's been great. I've made good friends. I've met amazing personalities who have had very creative ideas. And I think I've grown also while listening to all of them, to be honest. And so just to say that, be consistent in what you're thinking. Believe in the idea that you all have. And if you know, I've been available for anyone who wanted to reach out, be it in office or phone or Zoom. I've been available. Whoever still wants to get in touch, please do. And if I can help in any way, I'll be more than happy to. And it's been a great it's been great working with each and every one of you. And I wish you the best of luck for your respective projects. And I have no doubt that you will succeed by the help of everyone in this session, not just the mentors, but the directors. Everyone has their own skill set and level of expertise and contacts in the market. Wherever we can help you, I think we will all lend a hand to make your success. And best of luck. And thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Numan. And I just read a message in the comments, which I hope it's for everyone has seen it, about Numan, and the founders are praising and appreciating your time and efforts that you have invested in them. And after that, next, can we have Mr. Asif Jafri to say a few words?
Actually, Tawseef is about to disconnect, so maybe if Tawseef is still here, we
can hear from him. Sure, so can we have Tawseef first?
Thank you very much, Aram. It's been like, we have been together for a few weeks now, and I mean, it's very encouraging to see all of these founders to actually come forward and, I mean, grow to a level where I feel very confident about a lot of them. I mean, the pitches we have seen at the beginning is, I mean, that there's so very different in terms of, I mean, in almost so many aspects, that now I feel very confident that most of these guys have been pampered to a very good start now, and I wish all the best to them, and especially in some of the pitches they have given today, and some of the very insightful questions from Asif Jafri. I mean, I see a lot of what you call it. I mean, just hold on for a second. Sorry, actually, I was managing a few meetings along with today's session. So I'll actually have to leave now. All the best with all of you guys, and I will be happy to help you whenever you need. You guys have my number and my email. Let's be in touch. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Tawseef Saab. So.
Jafri. Ji, assalamu alaikum everyone, and congratulations everyone. This is such a delightful moment for all of you, and this should, you know, give you a very good lesson that, you know, despite whatever happening in the world, you know, life keeps on going. I'm very glad that because of no other reason, COVID chal raha hai, nahi chal raha hai, market kaisi hai. Things kept on moving, and today we are seeing that all of you are graduating. So I don't know if most of you know that, you know, I'm also a FI graduate, and I graduated from the first cohort of FI in Pakistan in Karachi, and I was also the only graduate of FI that was invited to Silicon Valley, and I was offered scholarship there, what I regularly say that, you know, you need to have a very strong why of your startup. And if you don't have a very strong why, you know, you'll soon give up, because the challenges you're going to face in the industry, in the market, going to be very, very tough. And living in a COVID era and post-COVID era, it is going to be very different. It is going to be very unprecedented as well. So a lot of assumptions that you have for your business right now are going to be challenged, and going to be challenged in many ways that you don't anticipate it right now. So your reason to start your business has to be very, very strong. You know, your why has to be very strong. Why I'm saying this, because I graduated from FI in 2015, and I am still pre-launched with respect to my startup. And you will be laughing at, you know, what am I doing? What am I cooking? And what's happening? A product that I've developed has a regulatory, you know, permission that is still in process, and I'm hoping to get it in 2 weeks' time from now. But the why is there, and the reason that I'm still on my project, it's been 5 years, is the reason why I'm telling you that you need to be very, very clear on your why. That's why you're starting. Because if you're excited about money, if you're excited about idea, so I can tell you that, you know, in a very near future, many of your colleagues, many of your entrepreneurs, fans will be doing some great work, will be getting some great press, and, you know, will be exciting, will be taking a lot of selfies on social media, and, you know, that might hurt you. But if you're very strong on your why, then none of that will hurt you. So I think we had very good two presentations at the beginning of this session. Yusuf Saab and then Brendan gave an amazing, you know, session, what I would call 20 minutes in Startup 101. He was spot on in terms of, like, you know, how you know, any factor of success to my journey is that I've been, Allah is extremely kind, extremely, extremely kind, that I've been, you know, I've been very good in terms of sales. I've built a very good sales team. I've been very successful in, you know, making continuous sale. And one of the best way to increase your sale is to have your customers speak good about you. Because if you have customers become your ambassador, you know, that's the best way to, you know, increase your sales. And the best way to get there is to get involved with them, you know, understand your data, what your data is saying. As you know, we saw the presentation of GoSpark. The data that was coming in is the market, which is completely ignored by the big players, the small, you know, pizza outlets, burger outlets. And, you know, maybe that's the market that you need to hit. So basically, sometimes you have to forget about what your
मुझे ऐसे क्यों लग रहा है आसिफ भाई की लाइट चली गई
आसिफ भाई की लाइट नहीं गई है भाई आसिफ भाई के घर की लाइट गई है यार खुदा का फोक
नहीं वो एकदम रोशनी कम हुई और उसके बाद वो फंस गए बेचारे वहीं पे
यार ये हमारी these are called third world problems
नहीं अच्छा ये हमारी ग्रेजुएशन में ये चीज ऑन रिकॉर्ड आ गया अच्छा ओके So we have Sayyid Naseh here as well as a mentor. So can we request Mr. Naseh to say a few words for the... Okay, Naseh sahab. Nahin, I think he has also left. Okay. Since Naseh sahab nahin hai, toh phir next I would, now as all the mentors are done, so I would request the directors, as they have been very hard working, especially Basit and everyone, obviously, including me as well. So the directors, please share your views and your experience and how have things been going on. Basit and Umar, who would like to be first?
I think Masood Saab should go first.
No, Masood Saab last mein aayenge. He's the regional director.
Acha, so phir aap shuru kare.
No, Basit and Umar.
Okay, yeah, so it's been a very interesting and long journey. I spoke to Masood last year and we have thought about to start FI Karachi chapter. It was started earlier in 2016-17, I guess. So In the beginning, we were struggling to get a right team, but after many pivots and iterations, luckily, we'll be able to have a good team. And alhamdulillah, after like effort of 4 months, extensive effort, during the recruiting events and after this semester. It's a moment of pride for all of you, and congratulations to all the founders, directors, especially to the mentors, and the effort and the time they have given into this program. So thanks to all of you, and I mean, itna asaan nahi tha ye kaam jo hum matlab ne socha tha, but especially after COVID-19, but good to see the effort and enthusiasm put by all the founders, the valuable time put given by the mentors to all the founders. I've been having office hour with the founders, and I've came to know that many of the mentors are already giving their time and assisting them. So it's very good to see the ecosystem is strengthening. One of the core reasons to join FII is to strengthen the ecosystem and empowering people to start business. So good to see that the dream is coming true. Thank you.
Okay. So Basit, roiyega nahi. Batai al kal baat mein. Ji, Umar, would you like to say something?
Ji, so it's been a very interesting journey. I think first of all,
video kahan hai? Umar, video.
Main is waqt andhere mein baitha hu. To agar main video on bhi karunga to mera khayal hai kala hi dikhega. But anyway. I just wanted to say that, you know, the journey of FI has been extremely, extremely illuminating. The best part of the journey are the connections that I've been able to make with all of you, with my fellow directors, with the founders, who you guys have been absolutely incredible. Honestly, jitna jitni mehnat aur lagan ke saath aap logon ne kaam kiya hai, theek hai, bahut zyada follow ups ki kabhi kabhar zarurat pad jati thi assignments mein, log piche reh jate the, kuch cheeze update karne mein bhool jate the, magar uske bawajood I know that, you know, having full time jobs and having many many commitments, coming up with the time and the energy at the end of a day, at the end of a long day, to sit down at 10 o'clock at night or 11 o'clock at night and work for a couple of hours on assignments, my literal hat is off to all of you. I've gotten the chance to work with some of you closely, some of you more closely than others, and I've really come to admire the spirit and the entrepreneurial blood that clearly runs through your veins. So I just want to say thank you for being part for all of us being on this journey together. I think has been an amazing experience for me. So thank you all, and I wish you all the best of luck. And if there's any way that I can help you in the coming months, please don't hesitate. You all have my contact info. Just message me, call me, whatever. I'm available to help. Thank you so much. And good luck and Godspeed.
Thank you, Umar. And last, we would like to have Mr. Masood Saab to share his experience and a few words about the cohort.
Right. So thank you, Iram, Umar, and Basit. I would say, first of all, fantastic job done. It's very difficult to run a chapter. And especially in these trying times, in the aftermath of the pandemic, you know, sort of retooling the whole experience and still delivering something that was as exceptional as what the Karachi cohort experienced. And I'm sure that there's a lot of learning. So the next semester would be even better, because now you would have ironed out how to be best, you know, at what you're doing and how to improve things even further. About the cohort, I'm very glad to see that 9 of you are graduating. This is exceptional. This is remarkable. And this is a testament to all the hard work that you've put in. But as I always tell all the FI chapters and all the people who are graduating, that FI certificate does not mean that you're going to win the race. It's just the knowledge that's more important than whatever certification that you get. And I think the 3 qualities that are going to make your journey a success are being, you know, tough, because toughness and persistence are the first quality that is required, no matter whether you're an FI graduate or somebody else. Then the second one would be flexible. You need to be very open to opportunities and to changing circumstances. So for example, a lot of startups are giving up. They are feeling stressed. They are saying our business model has disappeared. And what we say is, yes, that's all true. But the real entrepreneurs will stand up in this time of stress and they will find solutions, you know, to overcome all this and probably turn this into an even greater business. And we are witnessing that as well. And the last one is be prudent. And this is especially relevant for this time. So I think one of the biggest mistakes that startups do, and especially from platforms like FI, because you get a little bit more prominence than you would otherwise. And sometimes investors step in because they know how tough the program is. Then they are more willing to invest in you. Do not take more money than you need. Do not spend more than you need. And what is need, you need to define that. You don't need to buy probably the latest, you know, Macintoshes for your team, unless it's something that's very necessary. You don't need to splurge out on a fancy car or a big office table, you know. So you have to keep that bootstrapping mindset in front of you all the time, because that's the only way to succeed. And then finally, we are living in the age of data. So use data analytics, look at trends, get feedback, ensure that you're understanding what your customer wants, because the customer is at the center of the universe, right? I wish you all the best. I'm very, very glad that after Asif, and Asif has been a great support to the FI system right from the beginning. So when we started in Islamabad, we invited him over and he came on his own cost and dime. And he was very, very inspirational, motivational for the startups. And now, mashallah, we have a lot of cohorts that have graduated. We have Lahore that's starting out. We have NIC Peshawar and Karachi running our curriculum. And now we have the 9 new brave warriors out of Karachi. And I hope you'll go and conquer the world and, you know, contribute towards Pakistan's progress and prosperity. So thank you very much. And I'm again going to congratulate the directors and thank the mentors. Because without the mentors, the program cannot succeed. It is their experience, it is their expertise, it is their knowledge, and it's their love for the country that they take the time to support all the founders, and not because of the money and not because of the equity, the minute percentage that we dole out to them, but because they sincerely believe that Pakistan's progress lies with our startups and entrepreneurs. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Actually, Masood Saab, sorry, Iram, I would like to second what you said about Asif. So from the beginning of this cohort, Asif has stepped up and really made himself available, even though he's, you know, he's a very, very busy guy, as I can vouch for personally. So I think of Asif as founder prime, you know, jo hamare wo jo transformers mein jo prime hota hai, jo पहला फाउंडर होता है वो इस यहाँ पे इस हमारे इस स्क्रीन पे इस वक्त जो 10 फाउंडर है उसमें से एक प्राइम फाउंडर है और वो आसिफ जाफरी है. सो आसिफ अगेन स्पेशल थैंक्स टू यू यार, यू बीन देयर एट द
बिगिनिंग. पाकिस्तान से पहले बैच में सिर्फ 2 लोग ग्रेजुएट हुए थे, एक आसिफ और एक आई थिंक इट वाज हसन और व्हाट, 2 लोग ग्रेजुएट हुए थे, बट आसिफ इज द वन हु हैज रियली बीन देयर फॉर एवरीवन.
Standard bearer for FI in Pakistan.
Asif bhai, aap mute hain. We cannot hear you.
Actually, Lahore wala hua tha. Umar bhai ne jo thi tarif kar di, so I'm sure usko itna main kabil nahi hu. Lekin thank you very much, Umar bhai and Sayyid Ahmed. You guys have been inspirational yourself. Meri actually ye jo main support karta hu, isme meri apni journey bahut shamil hai. Main aap logo ko pata hai momentum bhi karta hu, usme tamam startups ko free cost pe Pakistan se travel karwate hain, rukwate hain, support karte hain. There's a reason, because my personal journey, I belong to you know, I come from a very humble background, and education and technology and entrepreneurial journey has, you know, given me so much that even in today's days and time when we're living in COVID era, you know, I'm enjoying financial freedom, and this brings a lot of opportunity for me to serve my neighborhood, my city, my country, and the world that we're living in. And you know, aajkal jo main kaam kar raha hu, so I would like to share that we are, mashallah, Allah is extremely kind that we are one of the very few companies in Pakistan that has not laid off any employee, that has not done any salary cut, that has in fact hired more people. In fact, we are also going for Eid for our employees because Eid is coming. So Allah is extremely kind, and you know, something that is what that was there in our control and something that is not in our control. So the things that are not in control, we believe that it's being directed from Allah Ta'ala, and that help us, you know, to do things. Jaise abhi ye COVID ka aap log jisko bhi call kar rahe honge to ek message sun rahe honge corona virus se bachne ki baba aur wo sari cheeze. I'm sure aap sab log ab bahut pak chuke honge, thak chuke honge sun sun ke galiyan bak rahe honge. This was my idea in the beginning when I realized that, you know, government of Pakistan has a lot of challenges in terms of reaching out to common man in the country. Ke COVID ki jo situation hai, COVID kitna khatarnak hai. So without, you know, incurring zero cost, government has reached out to almost everyone in the country. I mean, 165 million subscribers. This voice has been played over billions of times. So basically, this is a case study in itself. And now we are going towards, you know, doing a digital survey across all Pakistanis without doing, you know, suspecting COVID patients without having a lab test, because government has a very limited capacity to, you know, do a real test. So what I'm saying is, you know, what you are building here is not just for yourself. You know, the company that I started 12 years ago is now proving to be you know, playing a crucial role and part for our government as well, which we never thought of, that we can play our part at such level, such a scale. So, you know, think of your startup as a platform that in future that you guys will be playing significant role. But don't underestimate yourself. Don't think that, you know, you're just building a company that will help you to, you know, raise your lifestyle and, you know, you look cool. You know, think beyond that. You know, think like, you know, the company will survive. The company will change the landscape of this country, of this world, beyond your life. You know, so think really, really big. Think, you know, out of the world. Nobody's stopping you. It's just your brain. Sorry, I got disconnected because light went off. And this is exactly what I was referring to you, that, you know, we are going to see some, you know, very different feedback. So, you know, be ready for that. There, because times are changing, times are very difficult. People respond very, very rationally. So, you know, you'll be surprised. So basically be prepared for that. And I was telling you that, you know, look at the data of your company, what it is telling you, learn from that, read that very, very closely. Sometimes, you know, we aspire to build a company or run a startup that you have certain image of that in your mind. But, you know, keep that image with you. I'm not saying throw it away, but look at the data, you know, find out, you know, what your data is telling you. Maybe that's not a cool company. That's not a cool startup. That is not something that you, you know, you'll be proud to, you know, post on social media, but maybe that's a need that you have identified in a particular industry and you're going after that. And maybe you can make a $1 billion company out of that. So, you know, be flexible in that. And, you know, as what Sayyid Ahmed mentioned, that, having a FI, you know, graduation certificate does not guarantee that you'll be very, very successful. It totally depends on you. It's just a kind of a certification that you have gone through a process, and going through a process is extremely important, because when you'll meet investors, you know, they would know that you have successfully completed a program which has all the relevant model for your startup. It's not a BS. I'm sorry to use this word, but it is very, very hardcore learned process that, you know, Edu Resi has developed in US, you know, learning from all around the world. You know, say how many countries they're operating in?
We are, I think, 187 chapters right now.
187 so chapters and
about
so 50, many
50 plus countries.
So you see, this is not a bookish stuff. This is a real stuff that, you know, you are getting access to. So don't, you know, just take it for granted. And this documents that you are prepared, you must have, you know, submitted all your assignments. Keep those documents, you know, with you to go back again and again when you'll be going on a certain stage, as, you know, some of you are at a pre-stage. you know, you'll be going forward, you'll be going on a launch state, you'll be going on a customer development, you'll be going on a sales, you'll be going on an investor phase. So go back to those documents, what you wrote, and compare that, how much have you improved? Because without improvement, you know, you cannot go far. So big congratulations that you have made it so far. As Ahmed was saying that, you know, 19 members is phenomenal, because in my day and time, it was, we had like 24 teams, but only 4 graduated. So FI at that point in time was extremely brutal in terms of they were so happy in kicking out people. And it was like, how maybe it's against business model, but no, that is how they are. And if you interact with Edio, and in our time we had an opportunity, multiple opportunities to interact with him, and I had a chance to go and see him in the valley and had some session. He's extremely brutal. He is very, very cutthroat in terms of if what you're saying makes sense or doesn't make sense, if you are, you know, lying about something. So, you know, and that is how the business is, and that is how you should be. That is how you, you know, should be treating yourself, that it's no party. It's a real business. It's a real startup. You're out there with real customers, and you're solving real problems. So, and nobody cares. Nobody cares for your startup. You know, it's your own baby. It's your own responsibility. If you're doing well, you're doing well. If you're not doing well, nobody cares. So it really depends on you, how sincere you are with your startup, how much effort you're putting in, and where do you want to take it to. So forget about, $1 billion unicorn and all of that. Right now, the objective is to have a sustainability, right? The new normal that we talk about, you know, our human beings, that this is a new normal. We'll be operating from home. We'll be, you know, doing a lot of digital stuff. So what is the new norm for the startup? Is the reinvention all going back to the basics of the startup, which is to find a business model that is sustainable. Forget about, you know, Uber, Kareem, or WeWork kind of model where you're burning money and you're showing growth and you're, you know, accelerating on user acquisition. Focus on users that are going to contribute in your sustainability, in your profitability, because that's the only way you can sustain yourself. Funding in the coming times is going to be much more difficult. I have been to many investor sessions in last two, three weeks, and all of them are saying that either they are, you know, holding their money back, and or they're only investing in those startups and they're contributing in the second rounds, which have been proven, you know, successful in these times. So what I'm saying is, you know, don't go after that fancy model where you're showing growth, crazy growth, and you have a crazy burn. You don't know that, you know, if you're going to raise a second round or third round in this time and era. So focus on sustainability. Focus on the real proposition. And the kind of the entrepreneur that I am, I believe that you should only be getting funding in the first round. I'm talking about Pakistani environment. I'm not talking about Valley. So you should be able to raise funding to give you a quick start. And your business model should be sustainable, yet that at scale your model should be that, you know, you're scaling up and you're doing more transactions and you're becoming profitable. So don't follow that mindset that, you know, we'll be burning a lot of cash, we'll be showing a lot of growth, and, you know, that is how our win will be, and then we'll be making exit, or, you know, we'll be using advertising as a source of model. So, you know, get back to basic. That's my say right now. And again, coming back to FI stuff, you are very lucky. You have gone through a very, very successful model of, you know, particular steps of how to start a startup. And now it really depends on you, how you take it on. So what I can tell you, the knowledge that I have of Pakistan market of last, many years, is today we are 9. Next year, by this time, I'll be very, very happy. I'll be very surprised, and I'm hoping all of you will survive. But I think we are going to see half of the number that we have today. So only those who will be, you know, adapting to the situation will be willing to change the requirement of the customer or the industry that they're serving in, and watch very closely what's happening. So best of luck from my side. You have my number. I am, in Pakistan, I'm very well connected in telecom space, in banking space, in retail space, in FMCG space. Because I run one of the largest messaging and voice company, EOcean Private Limited. So we work with almost all sector, because we are in communication space. and mashallah, we are growing. So I have a very, very good penetration and very good relationship across multiple sectors. So I'm here to help you. I'm here to, you know, be a part of your successful journey. And let's see how we take it from here. But congratulations and best of luck for my side.
Thank you very much, Asif. It was amazing listening to you. And yes, as Umar rightly said, the primitive one, anyone else who would like to say something before we conclude? From the founders?
I think ab aap sab log apne aap ko unmute karein, video on karein, aur 10 second ke liye taaliyan baja lein apne liye.
Ek shot. Kya khayal hai?
Nahi, shout out chode, aap par taaliyan bajwa lein bhai.
Chalein, okay, everyone.
अनम्यूट करें सब लोग अनम्यूट करें प्लीज. आ जाए चले हो जाए तालियां. जुनैद भाई
ब्रावो
वेल डन एवरीवन.
एक मिनट तालियां बजाते हुए मैं कर लूं ना
स्नैपशॉट लेने
जुनैद
जुनैद भी आ गए.
जुनैद अस्सलाम वालेकुम. ताली बजाने
का सीन. Such an exciting day. So proud of everyone. Mashallah, mashallah, mashallah.
Junaid, would you like to say something?
नहीं, all I just want to say is mashallah.
Quick few minutes.
Bilkul Smokta sir, it was a wonderful experience mentoring at FI, and startups are amazing, and I just wish them best of luck for the future. They really have a potential, and I see them going forward a lot.
How was your experience as a mentor?
Wonderful, wonderful. It was a wonderful experience, and I think I like this. I like the arrangement from the FI, that the way things are structured and the way mentors are aligned, the way startups are trained throughout the journey in a very structured way. That's what I like most about FI.
Great. Any suggestions for future?
Keep up the good work. That's it.
Okay, thank you.
Welcome.
Aur koi kuch kehna chahega?
Nahi, I think एक चीज मैंने जो एक फीडबैक पहले भी दिया था और मैं उसी को रीइटरेट करूंगा एक बार फिर. दैट इज स्पेसिफिक टू मेंटर्स के. जाहिर है सबके लिए ही एक नया एक्सपीरियंस है था, फाउंडर्स के लिए भी, मेंटर्स के लिए भी. आई थिंक इन फ्रॉम मूविंग फॉरवर्ड जो एक इम्प्रूवमेंट मैं सजेस्ट करूंगा वो ये कि जब प्रेजेंटेशन या पिच हो रही होती है फाउंडर की, तो जो मैंने एक पर्सनली एक्सपीरियंस किया है वो ये कि मेंटोर्स जो हैं वो ज्यादा बिजनेस को कैसे मैं उसको एक्सप्लेन करूं कि उन सवालों में पड़ जाते हैं कि इज दिस बिजनेस वायबल और नॉट फ्रॉम द गेट गो. और वो जो एक मिनट दो मिनट का टाइम होता है वो उस बहस में चला जाता है कि मेंटोर कोशिश कर रहे होते ये समझाने की कि जो आप कह रहे हैं डजंट मेक सेंस. और फाउंडर क्योंकि अपनी महीनों की और समटाइम्स सालों की रिसर्च करके बैठा होता है
तो वो उसको में आ जाता है,
वो उसको बैटल आउट करने लग जाता है कि जी नहीं जो मैं कह रहा हूँ वो ठीक है. तो आई थिंक जो रोल मेंटोर्स का, एंड आई हैड द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू लुक एट द सिलिकॉन वैली वाले सेशंस, तो जो मेंटोर्स का फीडबैक खासतौर पे जो हॉट सीट पिचेस हो रही होती हैं, ठीक है जो आपका हमारा सेंटर में एक आया था माइलस्टोन और फिर अभी एंड में आया था, उसमें वी कैन हैव अ लॉन्गर डिबेट अबाउट द वायबिलिटी ऑफ द बिजनेस इटसेल्फ. बट जो इम्प्रूवमेंट लाने की जरूरत है वो पिच में लाने की जरूरत है, और स्पेसिफिकली उन एरियाज में के मेंटर्स बताएं कि यार आपने अपनी जो टीम को डिफाइन किया है उस वो सही नहीं किया, आपको उस पर ज्यादा टाइम लगाना चाहिए, आपका रेवेन्यू मॉडल जो है उस पर आपको थोड़ा सा ज्यादा टाइम लगाना चाहिए. इस तरह का बड़ा स्पेसिफिक फीडबैक हो जो कि पिच को इम्प्रूव करे हॉट सीट पिचेस में. और फिर उसके बाद जब हम फाइनली मेंटर रिव्यू पे आए या एंड में आए, उस पॉइंट पे फिर आके जो स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चंस हैं, क्योंकि हर बार मेंटर्स चेंज हो रहे होते हैं, तो वी कंटिन्यूसली जस्ट स्टे इन्वॉल्व्ड इन ट्राइंग टू प्रूव के जो हम कह रहे हैं वो सही है, एज इन द फाउंडर जो कह रहा है वो सही है. तो आई होप आई वॉज एबल टू गेट माई पॉइंट अक्रॉस कि प्रॉबेबली द डायरेक्टर्स शुड हैव अ सेशन विद मेंटर्स before starting the cohort, that this is your role in hot seat pitch and this is your role in the other kind of pitches, taake jo continuous improvement ka process hai wo chalta rahe founders ka, and they can understand ke how they want to make themselves better in every new hot seat. Kyunki from an assignment perspective, main personal experience bata do ke maine takriban 5-6 शायद प्री कोविड जितने भी असाइनमेंट थे उनमें सेम हॉट सीट पिच दी है. नोबडी टोल्ड मी व्हाट आई नीड टू इम्प्रूव, और मैंने वही कॉपी पेस्ट किया है, मैं ईमानदारी से बता रहा हूँ, और मैंने जो पिचेस दी है वो भी वही दी है. तो बिकॉज नोबडी टोल्ड मी के व्हाट आई नीड टू इम्प्रूव इन दैट स्पेसिफिक पिच, तो वो आई थिंक एज वी गो फॉरवर्ड वी नीड टू हैव दैट इम्प्रूवमेंट इन द प्रोसेस. Otherwise, phenomenal job. I've been to other places as well. I've been in this startup ecosystem for a while. Bahut andar se aur bahar se dekha hai, but I simply love this program. Main na sirf main khud isliye bhi guzra ki main bahut kuch seekhna chahta tha jo mujhe pata tha ki mujhe nahi aata, aur ये भी मैं करना चाहता था कि जो बाकी लोग जिनसे हम मिलते हैं बात करते हैं उनको भी आई वुड स्ट्रॉन्गली एडवाइज के दे शुड गो थ्रू दिस प्रोग्राम, एंड एनीवन हु हैज गॉन थ्रू दिस प्रोग्राम शुड बी टेकन सीरियसली, बिकॉज एवरी असाइनमेंट मेक्स यू वांट टू क्विट फॉर श्योर. एवरी असाइनमेंट वांट्स टू मेक यू क्विट. पहले दो तीन लोग तो भाग गए इसी असाइनमेंट को देख के. So if anyone has gone through this whole program, they are worth it, they are serious, and they should be taken seriously.
Yeah, Ayaz, I think, can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. We can hear you. Yes, जो आपका पॉइंट था फीडबैक के ऊपर, तो मेरी जो ऑब्जर्वेशन रही है पाकिस्तान में मेंटोर्स को लेके, I'm coming from a, you know, startup perspective, वो हमेशा एक्सट्रीम पे रहती है. या तो जब भी कोई आइडिया के पिच आती है तो ये सोचते हैं ओहो ये तो यार वही कॉपी पेस्ट आइडिया है, ऊपर करीम की कॉपी है, मतलब आई एम सेइंग के कॉपी पेस्ट है, जैसे बाहर होता था उसने वही आइडिया कर लिया. या फिर दूसरा जो है ओहो ये तो कोई अपोलो 2 बनाने के चक्कर में है, यू नो इज गोइंग ऑन अ मार्स, ही इज ट्राइंग टू बिल्ड एन एल्गोरिथम व्हिच इज बेसिकली गूगल कैन नॉट इवन मेक. सो हमारे यहाँ बेसिकली इन टू एक्सट्रीम्स पे रहते हैं. जैसे ही हम कोई आइडिया सुनते हैं, या तो ये बहुत ही रेगुलर सा आइडिया है या ये बेसिकली अनडूएबल है, ये पाकिस्तान में नहीं हो सकता, और ये बेसिकली इनका टीम बैकग्राउंड और इसका ये बैकग्राउंड और पाकिस्तान में तो चलता नहीं है. तो बेसिकली इन दो रेंजेस के बीच में रहता है, लेकिन वो उनका पर्सपेक्टिव है बिकॉज एवरीबडी इज कमिंग फ्रॉम अ सर्टेन बैकग्राउंड. उनका अपना एक्सपीरियंस है, कोई कॉर्पोरेट से आ रहा है, कोई एंटरप्रेन्योर है, और उसका भी बेसिकली अपने एरिया का एक्सपीरियंस है. वो उसको आपके एरिया का एक्सपीरियंस होना जरूरी नहीं है, बट क्योंकि हमारे यहाँ जो एंटरप्रेन्योर्स हैं, जो वो लोग जो मेंटर्स जो कि बेसिकली वाकई जिन्होंने अपनी जर्नीज कंप्लीट की हुई हैं, वो आके अपने रियल लाइफ एक्सपीरियंसेस शेयर कर रहे होते हैं, तो वो उनका जो बेसिकली जो पर्सपेक्टिव होता है हर सक्सेसफुल एंटरप्रेन्योर का, कि उसने अपनी कंपनी सस्टेन की होती है. तो जो और कंपनी में सबसे ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट चीज यही होती है, आपकी कंपनी के अंदर बहुत सारी चीजें ऊपर नीचे हो सकती हैं, प्रोडक्ट मार्केट फिट आज खराब है कल ठीक हो जाएगा, आपका एचआर का कोई चैलेंज है, आपके किसी और चीज का सप्लाई का कोई चैलेंज है, लेकिन अगर आपकी कंपनी सस्टेनेबल नहीं है यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू सर्वाइव फॉर नेक्स्ट 6 मंथ. तो इसलिए हमेशा जो मेंटोर्स होते हैं उनका ये फोकस होता है कि यार इस बेसिकली दिस माइट नॉट वर्क, दिस माइट नॉट वर्क, but if you are passionate and you are true believer of your idea, so basically listen to that from a perspective ke okay yaar mere liye koi yahan pe point of learning hai, maybe ye jo keh rahe hain kyunki journey guzar ke ja chuke hai ya ye isme is process mein hai, so there is some validity to it, so it's okay if somebody tells you, but at the same time you need to be cognizant of the fact ke yaar ye jo keh rahe hain ye apne perspective se keh rahe hain jo main kar raha hu mujhe ye karna hai aur main is pe theek rahunga jahan tak baat hai feedback ka ke yaar presentations ka aur iska to just don't rely on mentors or the team of directors that you have here you can always look up for best presentations online aapko ek search karenge na jaake aapko ek lakh milenge I'm sure you cannot even watch all of that there are 10,000 advices there are 10 billion advices out there on the internet so you can all look up for that and then certainly you can always record your presentation yourself and watch it that has always given me my best feedback to myself ke yaar main ye jo present kar raha tha agar ye jitni bhi aaj presentation to ye sare recorded hai aapke jo directors hain inke paas ye recording available hogi after the session so ask for them ki aap apna session dekhen aapne present kaisa kiya hai and you need to see it this presentation not to mentors but see it how you giving it to your client aap apne kyunki business aap client ke sath karenge na mentor ke sath thodi kar rahe hain मेंटर तो आपको सिर्फ हेल्प आउट कर रहा है आपके बिजनेस मॉडल फाइन ट्यूनिंग में लेकिन आपकी ये पिच जो है क्या बिजनेस को जब जा रही है तो क्या बिजनेस कन्विंस हो रहा है तो बिजनेस है क्या बिजनेस इज बेसिकली इज अ प्रोसेस ऑफ पीपल सेपरेटिंग फ्रॉम द मनी मतलब इट्स अ यूनिक डेफिनेशन दैट आई रोट इट कि बिजनेस है क्या यार बिजनेस ये है कि आप किसी को कोई चीज ऐसी चीज बेच रहे हैं जो पैसा उसके पास है वो पैसा आपको दे दे you are parting away people from the hard earned money they have made for themselves and you are giving them something ke jo se wo apni zindagi ki jama poonji wo apne paas nikal ke aapko de de wo business hai theek hai so aap apne pitches ko dekhen kya ye pitch itni powerful hai jo aap kisi ko de rahe hain to wo convince ho raha hai try to go in a customer seat and see ke yaar ye jo baat keh raha hai kya main paise kharch karunga kya tumhara jo ghost park ka platform hai does it make sense to me ya मैं नहीं करूंगा तो ऑलवेज लुक फ्रॉम दैट पर्सपेक्टिव राइट लुक एट योरसेल्फ के यार और डोंट रिलाय ओनली ऑन अ पर्टिकुलर सेट ऑफ पीपल या पर्टिकुलर सेट ऑफ सोर्स के यार यहां से मुझे चीज मिल रही है या चीज नहीं मिल रही है बिकॉज जो भी मेंटर्स यहां पे आ रहे हैं वो सारे यार वॉलंटियर्स हैं एंड दे आर कमिंग एंड पार्टिसिपेटिंग एंड गिविंग देयर बेस्ट शॉट टू योरसेल्फ So if they're giving you something, you're liking it, take it. If you think, okay, this is not something, give them feedback. Give directors feedback as you've just given. But, go online. It's a self-learning process. Startup journey is a lonely journey. It's a self-learning journey. You always keep on learning, मैं आज जो है ना जब मैंने ब्रेंडन का सेशन सुना है ना आप यकीन करेंगे if I can share my screen, मैंने उसके पूरे नोट्स बनाए as if कि मैं आज पहली दफा स्टार्टअप कोई बिल्ड करने जा रहा हूँ और मैं स्टार्टअप की पहली क्लास है तो मैंने बाकायदा पूरे नोट्स बनाए ना आई वाज लाइक वाओ यार दिस इज वेरी गुड रीकैप ऑफ हाउ द स्टार्टअप शुड बी एंड हाउ द फार्मर शुड बी सो ऑलवेज इट्स अ सेल्फ लर्निंग प्रोसेस अ लोनली जर्नी सो लर्न ऑल द वेज दैट यू कैन सो गुड फीडबैक बट द लर्निंग रिलाइज विद यू
ओके जी थैंक यू वेरी मच एंड जस्ट टू कंक्लूड
मैं एक फाइनल वर्ड कहना चाहूंगा कि आई सेकंड
जल्दी से बिकॉज़ हां फिर हम क्लोज कर रहे हैं
30 सेकंड I second Asif ke it's a lonely journey and FI has enabled us to be an ecosystem so that we are not lonely hum log whatsapp pe connected hai problems share kare ek dusre ke sath kal humne ek session rakha hai Islamabad graduates ke sath bhi usko attend kare aur build the ecosystem that we need
okay thank you very much and last to close off I would just like to say thank you very much agar aap sabko yaad ho jab hamara first session hua tha to what I said And I was expecting के हम सब जो हैं वो graduate कर जाएंगे, but somehow कुछ जो हैं वो drop out हो गए, जो drop out हुए हैं, they are not dropped out, gone forever. Next cohort में they can rejoin. So inshallah, hopefully we will make sure that next cohort में वो graduate हो जाएं. And you all will be serving as role models, and you all will be helping them. And
inshallah,
a very exciting journey, a very tiring. बहुत सारे मसले आए थे, फड़े भी हुए थे, and आप लोगों को as Ayaz said that every assignment पे वो ये सोचा जाता था कि we are going to drop out. So that was an experience. And आप लोगों की experience को देखते हैं, I was getting so excited. मेरा दिल चाह रहा था next time में instead of director, I join in as a founder, so that I can also experience the same thing. and I really feel that before joining as a director ke liye ye mandatory hona chahiye ki wo as a founder puri cycle complete kare and experience the feel and then become the director. So I think ye hona chahiye. So but other than that, everyone, thank you very much. And inshallah, aap logon ko kabhi bhi kahin pe bhi meri help ki zarurat pade ya any directors or any mentors, you are always welcome to contact us. Thank you very much and good luck for your future.
Thank you, Ji.
Thank you.
Allah Hafiz.
Thank you.
Allah Hafiz, everyone.
Allah Hafiz.
Allah Hafiz.
Allah Hafiz.